हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अगेन बैक विद द सेम टॉपिक इन कंटिन्यूएशन, एक्सपोनेंट्स। नाउ वील बी सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन एक्सपोनेंट्स। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर अबाउट द लॉज ऑफ एक्सपोनेंट्स। नाउ लेट्स सॉल्व सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस। इफ ए इक्वल्स टू 3, बी इक्वल्स टू 2, फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ a to the power b plus b to the power a. So a is given to us 3, 3 to the power, and b is given to us 2, 3 to the power 2 plus b to the power 3, 2 to the power 3 is there. So how many times 3 you will be writing? 3 to the power 2 is there, 3 into 3 plus 2 to the power 3, 2 into 2 into 2, 3 times we will be writing 2. Then we'll be multiplying 3 into 3, 9, plus 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8, 9 plus 8, 17. So like this we have find out the value that we have to find a to the power b plus b to the power a. Second part you'll be solving like this only. I have provided you the answer. So while solving it, do check it from here. To the question 2. Express them in the exponential form. We have to express them in the exponents form, that is to the power form we have to write it. First one, 288. Here we have find out the LCM of 288. I know, I hope that you all know the concept of finding out the LCM, because LCM concept I have already told in my previous video. If you are not aware of it, do check it in the chapter LCM and HCF videos. I have explained the concept of LCM by the division method. We'll be finding out the LCM and we'll be checking by which table it is going and how many times LCM we'll be finding out until we'll be getting 1 as our final value. So we'll be counting how many times 2 is coming here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2 to the power 5 it will become, and how many times 3 is coming? 2 times 3 to the power 2. So we'll be writing like this in our exponential form, 2 to the power 5 into 3 to the power 2. This is the concept of exponential form. First of all, we have to keep in mind the concept of LCM. You all should be aware about the concept of LCM, then only you can find out in exponential form. Then you'll be seeing how many times the value's been repeated and how to write in an exponents form. Second question also I have solved for you. That will be a practice question. You students have to practice it. I have provided you the answer. You can check it when you have done that portion. This is the second part of that only, in which we have to express in the exponential form. 1080. Again we'll be finding out the LCM and then we'll be solving it. This is your practice question. Do practice this question. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Question: if 27 into 32 equals to 3 to the power x into 2 to the power y. This is a LHS side, 27 into 32, and the RHS is 3 to the power x into 2 to the power y. We have to find out the value of x and y. So first of all, for finding out the value of x, we'll be expressing 27 in terms of 3 to the power, because base we have to make same, as LHS base will be equal to RHS base. So we'll be seeing 27, how many times it will go in the table of 3. 3 into 3 into 3, 3 to the power 3. Similarly, 32 will be seeing 2 to the power 5. That comes when we are opening this, we'll be getting 32 only. So 3 to the power 3 into 2 to the power 5 equals to 3 to the power x into 2 to the power y. From here we'll be getting the values of x and y. As 3 is the common base in the x1, so x is equals to 3 we are getting, and 2 to the power 5 equals to 2 to the power y. What is same? Base is 2. we have made the base same. It is very necessary that we have to make the base same. So y, how much we'll be getting? As the power is 5, y is equals to 5. Moving on to the fourth question. It is same copy of the third question. It is your practice question. Answer has been provided to you for your convenience. You students have to solve this question. If in any query, you can ask the doubt also. If 64 into 625 is equals to 2 to the power a into 5 to the power b. Here also we have to find out the value of a and b. In the previous one, the values we have to find out were x and y. Here a and b. Same concept we'll be applying. We'll be making the base same. Then we'll be finding out the value of a and b. In today's video, I have taken the same question and the practice questions of that also have been provided to you students. You have to solve these questions to make your concepts clear. In the next video lecture, I'll be further moving with the topic of exponent only. Till then, practice these questions thoroughly. Stay connected. Thank you for watching.